हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू द सेकंड लेक्चर ऑफ टोटल क्वालिटी मैनेजमेंट। दिस लेक्चर इज बेस्ड ऑन क्वालिटी डेफिनेशन एंड इट्स इंटरप्रिटेशन। आई एम प्रोफेसर ऋषिकेश कोल्ले, वर्किंग इन द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग इन संजीवनी कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग, कोपरगांव। लेट अस स्टार्ट विद द प्रेजेंटेशन। सो एज per the syllabus of the Pune University, first unit is quality in the construction and syllabus is as follows. So we'll move to the first point, that is quality. So what is quality basically? So if you ask about the quality, then the Oxford Dictionary defines quality as a degree of excellence, and you can say quality is a relative nature or a kind of character, or you can say also general excellence. And there are certain other meanings are also associated with the word quality, that are suppose a good product, you can say it's a sturdy, it's a durable, it is made up of the best material, it is easy to operate, or you can say it's a nice in appearance, or it has good touch, or the product which is produced with the care. These kind of things you can say according to the quality. But there are certain things which are associated with the quality that are identified by the various scientists from the total quality management, and that are known as gurus of the quality, total quality management. So first definition we'll see, that is given by the Deming. Okay. The quality, he says, quality is a predictable degree of uniformity and dependability at low cost and suited to the market. Okay. Second definition given by the Juran, it is what? It is the fitness for the use. How you can say how it is fitted for the use? Because it is serving the purpose. That is what Juran's perception. The Crosby says quality is conformance to the requirements. Okay, quality is what? It is the conformance to the requirements. Next, Taguchi says minimum loss imparted by a product. It is the minimum loss imparted by a product to the society from the time the product has been shipped. Okay, that is what? The quality. And one more definition given by the Feigenbaum, it is a way of managing little organization. You can say it is his views. And last definition is given by Hospin. He says it is correcting and preventing the loss, not living with the loss. Okay, you have to correct the loss, or you can say you can prevent the loss. That is what the quality. If you look about the broader view of quality, what is basically quality? If you ask the people this question, you will get a diverse range of answers. Okay, a good answer given in a seminar on good quality, that was quality is a perception. It is what? A perception. Quality could be all the things to all the people. Quality, like beauty, lies in the eyes of the holder of that product. Or quality, like any other concept that begins in the mind. Or quality is found in a great abundance or in our daily life. Okay, that is what. We live in a quality age, we in a quality home, we have full of quality furniture, we buy quality goods, we drive quality car, and we demand quality services from the others. But it is what? It is not the thing. In industry, this is the most commonly used word in day-to-day work. In fact, we'll see a lot of posters that are related to the quality. That posters themselves are, unless everyone is educated with the meaning of the quality, that are useless. Yes or no? So, without a clear understanding of the term quality, it is difficult to achieve it. Okay. So, there is a lack of understanding that gives rise to the ambiguous use, or you can say it's a word of quality. So it leads variation in the priorities. or decisions, actions or attitude. So that is what, if you ask what is quality, it is, you can say it's a perception. Okay, so that is what. Next, if you find the meaning of the quality, okay, next is meaning, we'll say. Meaning of the quality, if you have, it is depends upon anybody's perception, as we have said earlier. But here you can quantify the quality as you can say it's a performance to the expectations. Okay, it is what? It is the performance to the expectations. What performance you have achieved regarding what you have expected. That is what quality. If this ratio is greater than 1, then you can say it is good quality. If this ratio is less than 1, then you can say it's not of that much expected quality, but it is having some certain kind of quality in it. So that is what the quality. Next, here I have given certain flowchart. So above figure depicts the meaning of the quality from the producer's or from the customer's perspective. But the final determination of the quality is fitness for the use, fitness for the consumer's use, you can say, which is not, which is a consumer's view about the quality. Okay, it is consumer who makes the final judgment regarding the quality, and it is so the consumer's view, and that should be dominant over here. Okay, so that is what the quality. If you look about the importance of the quality, that is next slide here. This I will start this with a basic idea. Okay, so it is a well-known fact that suppose that organization, or you can say it's a company, or it's a business, or you can say it's a non-profit organization, it is a very complex system which is primarily designed to add values to all the stakeholders. Okay, which are those stakeholders? Suppose there are employees, there are employers, legal owners are there, staffs are there, customers are there, business partners, authorities, etc. Okay, so any organization that uses a management system to determine the needs of each stakeholder, to transform the needs into the internal requirements, or to provide the resources that are needed to meet all the requirements, or also you can say to view or to review the performances. So this is what that figure is saying. There are, you can say, many definitions for the you can say management system, but I will give certain examples. Two examples I will give. First, suppose a management system is a framework of processes and procedures which are used to ensure that a organization can fulfill all the tasks which are required to achieve its objectives. Okay, or second example, it is a management system that describes the set of procedures or organization that need to follow in order to meet the objective. That is what. But what is important here? It is important here, suppose the management system or the quality organization should be there. Each organization is unique, you know, and it has own identity and its structure. So each organization must develop their own quality management system, so that can be used for continuously improvement. Okay, there should be continuous improvement should be there, then it will be good for the organization, and whatever the predetermined needs are there, that can be achieved. So you have to go in this way. Okay, so that is what the about the importance of the quality. Suppose if you see the importance of a quality from the perspective of the project, okay, this is what, from the perspective of a civil construction project, this figure shows the framework of quality for construction project success. So let us have the project, construction project example, in which how a quality is important parameter in all framework of the project. So how it is important? So if you see the construction project life, it goes in different phases. Okay, there are various phases. The main phase of the project can be described as conceptual phase, feasibility study, design, then procurement, then construction, then acceptance, operation, maintenance. These are the phases are there. So what is their quality is what? It is a critical factor in the success of construction project. So quality of a construction project is linked with critical factors in the, you can say, proper quality management should be there in all phases of project life cycle or in the PLC. So the design and construction are two important phases, okay, of a project life cycle, which affect the quality outcome of the construction very significantly. Okay, so further, quality of a construction project can be regarded as a fulfillment of the expectations of the project participants, that are stakeholders of the project, by optimizing their satisfaction. And it is because, since the quality outcomes of the project are not according to the required standards, so if faulty construction takes place, so further errors of the project are there, then frequently it is going on. So that is what quality. In fact, suppose if you see 6 to 15% of the construction cost is found to be wasted due to the rework or the defective components that are detected late during the construction, and only 5% if you see the cost is wasted due to the rework of defective components, okay, that are detected in during the maintenance. So hence, quality has become one of the most important competitive strategic tool which may construction organization have, and this is what you can say that is realized by themselves to develop their building products or supporting the continuous processes. So from all this perspective of the construction company, there should be quality management in the construction projects, and should mean the maintaining the quality of the construction works at required standard so as to obtain the customer satisfaction. Okay, that would bring long-term competitiveness, and that will survival, that will be the survival for the companies. If you think of further adoption of the quality in the construction industry, that has been promoted in certain literatures like this, the application of the ISO standards that are received much attention from the researchers. Okay, so ISO certification nowadays is a trend in most of the industries, okay, in the construction industry. So thank you for this and in next lecture we'll see various factors affecting the quality.